I'm Erica Gamet with InDesign Secrets. In this video, we're going to look at cropping images in InDesign. If I place an image in InDesign using the File menu, Place, and choosing my image, and dragging that image out to size, it automatically creates the frame to the proportions and the orientation of my image. But maybe I want to show just one part of an image, or I want to fit a wide photo into a tall frame. I can do that as well. I'm going to hit Undo, just steps me backwards, back to my Place cursor, and I'm going to hold down the Shift key while I draw up my frame. Now I have more control over the size and the orientation and the proportions of my frame. Just make this tall and let go. Now by default, this is how the image fits inside the frame, and I need to fix that really quickly. I'm going to go up to the Object menu, go under Fitting, and choose to fill frame proportionally. Now it fits in that size frame, but it doesn't exactly fit the way I want it to inside this frame. I want to show the whole Ferris wheel. And there's a couple ways to do that. When you place an image in InDesign, you're actually creating a frame and then placing the image inside it. So there are actually two components to this image here. We can manipulate each one of those components individually. Let's start with the frame first. I'm going to use the selection tool for both of these. I'm going to go ahead and grab the frame, and I'm just going to move it off to the left a little, so I have room to pull out the frame to fit the image that I want to show. With my selection tool selected, I'm just going to go ahead and grab one of the grab handles on the frame itself. And I'm going to click and pause for just a second so that I can see sort of a ghosting of the image back behind. I'm going to grab this left handle as well and move that in a little bit. And now we have a nice tall frame, but now the image fits in the frame the way I'd like it to. But sometimes the frame needs to stay where it is, and we need to move the image instead. I'm just going to undo, get back to where we were when we first placed that image and it was off to the side. And what I really want to do is leave the frame where it is and move the image to the left a little bit. To do that, I'm going to take advantage of a little guy that doesn't show up until we roll over the image. We get this circle in the middle, this translucent circle. This is the content grabber. And what that does is allow us to switch back and forth between manipulating the frame and the content of the frame. If it's not on, you can go up to the View menu under Extras and choose Show Content Grabber. It's already on, so it says Hide Content Grabber for me. So we've placed our image inside our tall frame and told it to fill frame proportionally, but now we need to move the image over, leaving the frame where it is. I'm going to roll over the image to that content grabber till I get that little hand. And I'm going to click and again hold for a second and start dragging. Now I can see the image back behind. Now, one thing I don't want to do is move the image too far up or down because I end up with white space inside my frame. So I can hold down my Shift key, which kind of keeps the movement only going in one direction. So I'm going to move that exactly where I want it, holding down the Shift key, and I let go. And now I've left the frame where it is, but I've moved the image to crop it how I'd like. One last trick when it comes to manipulating and cropping images is that sometimes you like the relationship between the frame and the image itself. I like the way this is cropped, but I realize I want the entire image to be smaller. And maybe we're going to move it into the upper left-hand corner. When I use the selection tool, and I grab on the frame and move it, the frame and the image move as one thing. But now I want to size this down as one thing as well. But if I just grab that handle and size it down, it just crops the image. That's not what we want. I'm going to hit undo. I need to hold down a couple more keys for this. I'm going to roll over the corner handle, hold down the command or the control key, and I'm also going to hold down the shift key to constrain my proportions. Then I'm going to click and wait for a second just so I get this nice image so I can see what's actually happening as I size this down. By holding down the command or the control key, the image and the frame work together as one unit. So I can constantly change the size, let go, grab just a handle, that changes the size of the frame. Roll over the middle, grab the content grabber, and move just the image itself. And that's just a couple ways that you can crop and manipulate images in your InDesign document. Well, I certainly hope you found this tip helpful. Be sure to check out InDesignSecrets.com for thousands of InDesign articles and tutorials, and to subscribe to our monthly publication, InDesign Magazine. Thanks for learning with us.